To begin this event with, may I now call upon Dr. Annurag Batra, Chairman, Editor-in-Chief of Exchange for Media Group and BW Business World, on stage, please. And the applause can go on, my friends. Come on. Thank you.
Sacrificed his lunch and he was polishing off on his presentation. Mr. Shyam Singhania was an investment banker, chairman of Inar Capital, my partner Nawal, all my editorial colleagues from Business World and Exchange for Media, and industry leaders. I said Mr. Sudhanshu Vats is a special person to do this. For many, many years in media, we worked with professionals and leaders from the media industry, and that's good. That's not a bad thing. But if you look at some of the media companies that have grown, and they have grown and transformed, and they've grown at a scale that wasn't envisaged when those companies existed, was because they got leaders from outside the media industry. And again, a lot of people have, my friend Suresh is there, a lot of people have a different point of view on that. But my personal point of view is, when me and Nawal and Amit started Exchange for Media, we didn't come from the media industry. I and Nawal did what most Indians do before they do anything. We went to an engineering school, then we went to a business school, and we didn't start Exchange for Media to build a media company. We wanted to build a marketplace for media advertising communication, and we tried that for about 3.5 years. We were ahead of time because we started it in 2001. The reason I'm saying, because we were outsiders, we had no clue. We had no limits on ourselves. We just kept doing what kept coming along and opportunities that were thrown our way. So in that sense, the point I'm trying to make is, you looked at the AV of the Viacom group, the Viacom 18 media group. Mr. Watts, who comes from Levers, has been at the helm of affairs for more than 7 years. And I think he's just getting started. And his own, while the theme today is transforming businesses in the digital age, his theme is harmonizing chaos in a new world order. That could be the billboard in every media company, especially our office, because we in the media industry are dealing with challenges that are unprecedented, technology challenges, audience challenges, cost pressures, being futuristic, the entrepreneurial opportunities it's throwing for colleagues in the business, which creates its own turnover. So really, he has transformed the business, grown the business, and is now harmonizing his own business in a way that the 800 million people that Viacom 18 Media Group reaches out to are able to enjoy new worlds. So I hope when you listen to him, you will get something that has a structured perspective, has the benefit of experience that comes from building a large media company that he's built, and third, being futuristic and thinking 5 to 10 years ahead, because the kind of background he has been trained to do that. Since I and Nawal are part of the ecosystem, I don't want to keep a long presentation, but I have 2 slides to show. And these are, you know, I got them on a WhatsApp from a friend, 2 different friends, and Ravneet, the first one. You know, because you can't talk of marketing audiences without talking of digital. They're kind of synonymous. And I got this yesterday. They said the old saying of 7 sins, when it's applied to the marketing world, and you know, the 7 sins in digital world are accomplished. Lust is accomplished through Tinder. I'm not on Tinder. Neither is Mr. Watts nor is Nawal. I can talk about them. Gluttony, I don't need it. I am not on Yelp, you know, but I have other ways to fulfill that. Greed, LinkedIn. I am on LinkedIn, but I'll tell you, my being on LinkedIn has nothing to do with greed. It's, you know, I will, you know, it's a daily activity for me to put thoughts, because I get feedback from the community that it helps them. It helps me, certainly. So I do it as a way of giving back, but I understand what it's trying to say. Sloth, which is Netflix. I wouldn't call it sloth. I would have called it something else, but because it's trying to put it in a context. Wrath, Twitter, that I definitely agree. And envy is Facebook, you know. Everybody's life on Facebook is like, you know, Donald Trump's life or whoever's life you like, you know, Ranveer's life or Shah Rukh's life. And pride is Instagram. I've recently gone onto Instagram and, you know, I'm trying to be Instagram friendly. I also got another WhatsApp, Ravneet the second. And, you know, in an increasingly digital world, the fact that we are doing this conference face to face, the fact that you're in the room, and we keep talking about this impact of technology and what machine learning and artificial intelligence will do to our business. But the human touch will always have a premium and it'll always stay. You know, the value of being able to have a conversation or kill somebody, not literally kill, but kill in a conversation, you can't get that on. I mean, Twitter cannot give you that experience. But the more we are connected, this is a word I came across recently, JOMO, the joy of missing out, feeling content with staying in and disconnecting as a form of self-care. And its antonym is FOMO. So really, we live in a very paradoxical world. We want JOMO and we want FOMO. So marketing today has become about dealing with paradoxes. I want to end by saying, I've given this example in the past, and I would like to give it as my parting example. I'm a student of marketing, so I don't know enough. I'm learning. I like that song called Higher Ground from UB40, the more I know, the less I know. I want to say that the stereotypes are changing. There is a new normal. And though it's now an 18-month-old movie, I'll refer to Ocean's 8. It is an all-women's cast. When we watched Ocean's 11 and Ocean's 13, we could have never imagined of a Ocean franchise having all women cast. So the role models are changing. What consumers and citizens and individuals are looking up to is changing. So really, marketers have to keep pace. And nobody knows enough. I think we live in a world where nobody knows enough. And we are constantly being bombarded with content. So increasingly, brands play a larger role. I would like to say that in a world where there's so much uncertainty, there's so much flux, brands continue to be the guiding force. Today, when you talk to millennials and young leaders, they not only talk of their families, their grandfather, father, mother, but they talk about their experiences and their interfaces with brand. Some of those experiences and interfacing are defining moments of these millennials' life. So in this increasingly connected, digital, paradoxical world, brands show the way because leaders are failing. Thank you. God bless you.